Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about walks, trails, paths, cycles, and circuits. Let's start with a real-world example. Suppose you have a network of cities connected by roads, represented by a graph of vertices connected by edges. A walk through this network would be equivalent to traveling between some sequence of cities. You're allowed to visit the same city as many times as you like, and you're allowed to use the same road as many times as you'd like. If after your walk, you ended up at the same city that you started from, then we call that a closed walk. If you ended your walk on a different city than you started from, we call that an open walk. Now, when you have a walk like the one you see here, one way you can represent it formally is with a list of vertices alternated by edges, as seen here. The general format of this list representation is shown beneath, where the V's are vertices and the E's are edges, and the endpoints of any edge EI are VI and VI plus 1. In other words, the endpoints of each edge in the list are the preceding and succeeding vertices to that edge in the list. Here's an example of a walk in a graph. You can see its list representation in the upper right-hand corner. Now, what if we imposed a restriction on our walks, that we cannot repeat edges? Here's one such walk. A walk in which edges are not repeated is called a trail. Like walks, trails can be open or closed. Open trails end on a different vertex than they started from. Trail DGEF is open. Closed trails end on the same vertex that they started from. Trail DGED is closed. In a simple graph, that is, a graph in which there are not multiple edges between a given pair of vertices, a trail can be uniquely identified by an ordered list of vertices, as I've been showing you along our previous two trail examples. The length of a trail is the number of edges traveled in that trail. The length of the two trails I've shown you, DGED and DGEF, are therefore 3. Now, you should know that a closed trail, that is, a walk in which we do not repeat edges, and in which the starting and ending vertices are the same vertex, is known as a circuit. Again, since a circuit is merely a closed trail, we are still allowed to visit the same vertex more than once, but we cannot travel along the same edge more than once. Here's an example of a circuit, EGDABDE. Let's impose even more restrictions on trails. What if we do not allow ourselves to repeat vertices or repeat edges? Then we have a path. Here's another example of a path in this graph. Note that there is an exception to the no repeated vertices rule. We are allowed to repeat the first and last vertex in our path. If we do so, we have what is known as a closed path. The restriction to not repeat vertices is sufficient to also prohibit us from repeating edges, as there is no way to repeat an edge without also repeating a vertex. It's important to know that a closed path is also known as a cycle. Here are two examples of cycles in a graph. As we covered before, since trails can be uniquely identified by an ordered list of vertices, and since paths, cycles, and circuits are just types of trails, we can represent paths, cycles, and circuits with an ordered list of vertices as well. It's helpful to know that some authors use the word path to refer to open path only, in which the starting and ending vertices are different. Also, Notice that a cycle is a circuit in which vertices are not repeated. In other words, the set of circuits in a graph includes all of the cycles in that graph as well, as the only requirement for something to be a circuit is that it is closed and does not repeat edges. A cycle meets this requirement, and so it's a circuit as well. Summarizing, there is a kind of hierarchy to walks and graphs. The most general kind of walk through a graph is, well, a walk. Then we have the distinction between open and closed walks, where an open walk starts and ends on different vertices, and a closed walk starts and ends on the same vertex. Then we can define trails, which are walks without repeated edges. And we can further categorize these into open trails and closed trails, also known as circuits. And then we can define paths, which are trails where we do not repeat vertices, remembering that we also have open and closed paths, which are also known as cycles. As mentioned before, some authors do use slightly different terms for some of these concepts, and I've left examples of that in the description of this video. But what's most important is to grasp the idea of walks through graphs with different levels of restrictions on them. That is, walks where we can repeat edges, walks where we can't repeat edges, and walks where we can't repeat vertices or edges. Also remember to distinguish between walks that finish at the vertex where they started and walks that finish at a different vertex from where they started. The graph theoretic concept of walks is highly applicable to the real world. Suppose we model a network of cities and roads as a graph of vertices and edges, and then we apply weights to the edges in our graph, assigning each edge a value that describes the length of that segment of road in the real world. In such a weighted network, the weight of a path is the sum of the weights of its edges. We could then consider all of the various paths between two cities and find the path with the smallest weight to be the shortest real-world path between those two cities. While this is a very simple example, questions of finding the quickest or shortest route in a network of cities or locations can get very complicated and can be very important to a host of industries. The traveling salesman problem, for example, is a more complicated problem. It asks, if we have a weighted graph like this, where each vertex represents a location, each edge represents the path connecting two locations, and the edge weights represent the distances between two endpoint locations, what is the shortest possible route? That is, what is the route with the smallest weight that visits each vertex in the graph exactly once and returns to its starting vertex? This problem sees applications in microchips, DNA sequencing, and logistics. That's it for this video. In my next video, we'll apply our new terminology to two very important kinds of walks: Hamiltonian paths and Hamiltonian cycles. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.